All right, we are looking at 4-3. Day one. Okay, we're going to get another derivative rule. So have your blue sheet handy. And today we're going to do the derivative of quotient. The derivative of a quotient of two functions. So if f of x equals g of x divided by h of x. So here you're going to have an x term divided by an x term. I'm going to switch to the u's and v's. I think it's a little bit more streamlined. So if y equals u divided by v, then the derivative is, and it's a little bit more complicated than the product rule, you take the derivative of the top times by the bottom, subtract the top times the derivative of the bottom all over the bottom square. So go ahead and add that under the quotient rule for derivative on your blue sheet. So you've got that handy. And now we're just going to practice this today. I'm not going to get into the story problems or anything too tricky. It's a lot of algebra. So let's go. We've got y equals 7x minus 2 over 3x plus 4. We want to do derivative. Okay, you see an x term, it's a function, linear function divided by this linear function that has an x divided by x is quotient. So y prime will equal the derivative of the top, derivative of 7x is 7, that's a 0, times by the bottom. Subtract, keep the top the same, times by the derivative of the bottom, that's just a 3, that's a 0, all over bottom squared. Okay, calc done. Now we do some algebra to simplify that numerator out. So we're going to distribute a 3 here. That's going to give us 21x plus 28. Here, I'm going to distribute a negative, and I'm going to distribute the 3 at the same time. That's going to be a 21, negative 21x, minus 21x, that's minus 6, distribute that negative, and get plus 6. All over 3x plus 4. And just combining like terms in the top, the x cancel each other out. And I've got 28 plus 6 is 34 over the quantity 3x plus 4. Quotient rule. Number 2. So x plus 2, y equals x plus 2 over cosine 3x. X divided by x, quotient rule. Take the derivative of the top. Derivative of x is 1, 0, by the bottom. So I didn't need the 1, I didn't need the parentheses. Subtract, keep the top the same, and parentheses, so we have two terms to it, times by the derivative of the bottom. So all you're focused on is the cosine. Derivative of cosine is negative sine plus 3x is the angle, times by the derivative of the angle is 3. All over bottom squared. The parentheses, or put the squared by the cosine, by the x. Alright. Simplifying that, cosine 3x. Here, the minus minus is going to come out, make that a plus. I'm going to choose to multiply. I've got three things multiplied. This, times the 3. I'm going to distribute the 3 into this. The negative's coming out here. So I'll have still parentheses. 3x plus 6 times minus 3x. I could distribute the sine of 3x, but I don't think that's going to make it look any better. I'm not even going to bother. I'm not going to simplify anything. Of, and I'm just using that goofy notation so you get used to seeing it, cosine of 2x divided by x. So again, that just means take the derivative of this function. So that's definitely a quotient rule, so it's x divided by x. I'm just going to say that the derivative equals, and jump right into quotient rule. The derivative of the top, derivative of cosine is negative sine. 2x times by the derivative of the angle is 2. Top times the bottom minus the top. Derivative of the bottom is 1. All over bottom squared. Okay, simplifying. I'll have a negative 2x. Sine 2x minus cosine 2x all over x squared. Okay. Common mistake is to cancel an x here. You are not allowed to cancel an x out of one basket like this. It would have to be in both baskets so that I could factor it out and cancel it. I'm sure that's coming up soon, but there is no simplifying that can be done here as far as that goes. Here's where we can do some work. Number 4. Y equals 4x plus 3 to the 6 divided by 2x minus 5 to the 3rd. Okay. Definitely quotient rules. X divided by x. And we're going to factor and simplify. So, derivative. Derivative of the top, power rule, or I mean the chain rule, outside first, is 6. Times 4x plus 3, like this. And the inside derivative is 4. Nothing there. Times by the bottom. And we'll subtract. Keep the top the same. Derivative of the bottom is 3 times 2x minus 5 squared, and the inside derivative is 2 all over the denominator squared. That's cubed, and then we're going to square that. And you tell me the rule there on the next line. I guess you're not here. Okay. Simplifying, I'm gonna have a 12 here. All right, 24. Here I'm going to have 6. What I want to do at this point, like we did in the other section, think of the numerator as two baskets that we need to factor and simplify. So in this basket, I've got a 24, and this one I've got a 6. So I can take out the 6. I've got 5 of these. And here I've got 6 of them, so I can take out 5 of them. here I've got 3 of these 2x minus 5, so I've got 2, I can take out 2 of them. And then I'm going to say what's left in each basket. So, out of the 24, when I divide out a 6, there's a 4 left. All 5 of those are out in front. There were 3 of these, I only took out 2. That leaves a 2x minus 5. Got to subtract 5 between the baskets. The 6 got pulled out in front. I had 6, I took out 5, I got 1 of these. And then 2 of these all got taken away. Now I just go all over this. When you've got a power raised to a power, you multiply. So the bottom is 2x minus 5. Okay, just got to work here. I'll do that right now. It's going to give me an 8x minus 20. Here, it's going to be a negative minus 4x minus 3. So it's 6. 4x plus 3 is 6. 2x minus 5 squared. 8x minus 4x is 4x minus 23. All over 2x. Now, is there any simplifying you can do between the numerator and the denominator? Look, these are all multiplied, these are all factors. I can cancel common factors between numerator and denominator. Because I've got 2 of these here and 6 of the same thing down here, I can cancel out 2 of them. So these are going to be completely gone. And I have 4 of these left. So my final answer is 6 times 4x plus 3 to the 5th. 4x minus 23 all over 2x minus 5 plus 4. There's your final answer. Okay. Lots of work when it doesn't have this trig function in it and we have to do the backing of simplifying. But look how much smaller it got from where I started. So that does simplify quite a bit. Your last one of the day, you get to do 2 ways. Here we've got f of x equals 4 divided by 3x to the 5th. You can think of this as a quotient. Even though it doesn't have an x term, you could say it's like x to the 0, but you could do a quotient rule here. That's going to be one way. And then we're going to do it with rewriting it first. So find derivative 2 ways and show that they are the same. Find derivative 2 ways, show that they are the same. So our first way is going to be quotient. Quotient rule says take the derivative of the top. Well, what's the derivative for? 0. Multiply by the bottom. And subtract. The numerator. Multiply by the derivative of the denominator, which is just going to be 15.